coming to the show. Imagine catching your lover in the arms of another. Have you ever felt so betrayed it left your heart in pieces?
Oh, I know.
Well, my guests today say they're tired of their lovers' scandalous ways. They say they're not backing down as these jealous lovers do battle.
It's been 1 week since we got to see cheating lovers and cousins that marry. 5 days since they had the show with the hermaphrodite, the slut, and the crack hoe. 3 days since we heard the tale about the guy who learned his woman was a she-male. Yesterday, it occurred to me that I've been watching a bit too much Jerry Springer. Holy cow, did you see it last week? Well, I had this one freak who sucker punched his whole family. Do you recall when the brawl became a total free-for-all and Jerry's in the middle trying to be the referee? Hey, see the stripper with the implants? She likes to lap dance and date the boyfriend of her mother. Now here comes Jerry's next guest, and it's a slugfest, cause it's a trailer trash brother. Nymphomaniac is back on crack. It's like when animals attack, they all exhibit reprehensible behavior. Hit them in the nose, they're off their clothes, they're on their toes. That's how it goes. They get so violent, they have to sign a waiver. They're always roaring, cursing, kicking butt, and pointing blame. On the air, they don't care, they got no shame. There was one guy who I'm sure felt a little strange when he found out that his wife had a sex change. They have a tendency to scream and yell constantly. They have a history of ripping off their shirts. It's been 1 week since they had the fight with the Siamese twins and the transvestite. 5 days since that awful brawl, they still haven't got the blood off the wall. It's been 3 days since the bitter feud between the KKK and that gay Jewish black dude. Yesterday finally dawned on me, I'm spending way too much time on that Jerry Springer.
Baby, I've been sleeping with your sister.
Oh, which one?
All of them.
Oh, well, I've been sleeping with your best friend Jake.
Yeah, well, me too.
Oh.
And I've been sleeping with your dog Woofy.
Woofy, you bitch. Well, I'm also sleeping with your pet goat.
That goat doesn't love you.
Once you start watching, there's just no stopping. Your brain shuts down and your IQ's dropping. Jerry's the king of confrontation. He's a sensation. He puts the same in syndication. It's totally worthless, like a bad check. It's like a train wreck. Don't want to stir, but you can't look away. Like Sally Jesse, he does talk shows, but with more weirdos. The ratings jumping higher every day. If you've seen the show, well, then you know it's just as low as you can go. The guests are tacky and they're lacking in their hygiene. And pretty soon some ugly goo come in the room, and then it's boom in the face of some unsuspecting drag queen. Well, it's the kind of show where people scream obscenities, yanking hair, throwing chairs at their hobbies. Jerry, now the crowd starts their favorite chant. Should I turn off my TV? I just can't. I have a tendency to watch it religiously. I have a history of taping each one. It's been 1 week since the show about psycho killers with problems they should work out. 5 days since the big surprise when some loser's wife said that she's still dating 20 guys. 3 days since he interviewed a bunch of psychic porn star midgets who are all new. Yesterday, it occurred to me that I've been watching a bit too much Jerry Springer. Kinda wasting my time on that Jerry Springer. I got way too much class to watch Jerry Springer. Come over here and pull on my finger.
Most of our guests today haven't revealed that level of seriousness, and until they do, what we see here aren't relationships, but rather long dates. Till next time, take care of yourself and each other.